The future of agriculture. In conventional agriculture, plants are raised as in a flower pot. Soil is shredded and aerated, growing plantlets are supplied with plenty of fertilizer, and any unwanted organism is removed. Our crop plants have been adapted to such conditions by intensive breeding and are depending on them. This way, cheap food is produced in large amounts, the essential basis of our current way of living. In the long run, however, this practice leads to squandering of limited resources and to compromising natural habitats. This video summarizes important issues and discusses possible alternatives. Plowing. Plowing needs much energy and is one of the main drivers of agricultural energy consumption. Plowing also destroys soil's natural structures and thus enhances erosion and soil compaction. Soil organic matter is more rapidly decomposed in plowed soils, resulting in an increased release of mineral nutrients. In addition, plowing impairs most soil organisms, detrimental or not. No-till farmers, doing without plowing, save large amounts of fuel. Due to no-till, soil organisms like earthworms are restored, resulting in the loosening of compacted soils, and soil organic matter is rebuilt. Soil organic matter is an important factor of soil fertility. In the initial years of rebuilding soil organic matter, however, there is an increased need of mineral nutrients in no-till agriculture. Furthermore, no-till will promote weeds and harmful organisms. Therefore, no-till may result in an increased need of pesticides. No-till farmers, for example, often use herbicides like glyphosate for eliminating competing vegetation prior to seeding of crops. Mineral fertilizers. During harvest, mineral nutrients are removed from agricultural plots. These nutrients have to be replenished by fertilization. Organic farmers are using complex organic fertilizers, like for example manure, for this aim. When applied in correct amounts, this kind of fertilization minimizes leaching of nutrients and damage to non-agricultural ecosystems. Compared to organic fertilizers, mineral fertilizers are easy to handle and are providing nutrients to the plants more rapidly. In the case of nitrogen, however, large amounts of energy are necessary for fertilizer production. All other mineral fertilizers are obtained from mineral deposits. At least in the case of phosphorus, the depletion of these deposits is already foreseeable. Furthermore, mineral fertilizers are washed off the fields more rapidly than organic fertilizers, affecting non-agricultural ecosystems considerably. Coulton fertilization has been established as an innovative approach to fertilization. Fertilizer is not applied throughout the whole area, but rather injected close to the root systems of individual plantlets. This more targeted approach reduces waste and leaching of fertilizers. Pesticides. Conventional agriculture raises genetically identical plants under optimized conditions on large areas, providing ideal conditions not only for plants, but also for pests. Thus, weeds or detrimental organisms cannot be controlled without pesticides. Health risks for consumers connected to this practice appear relatively low, at least in industrial countries. There are clear negative environmental consequences of pesticides, however. Most pesticides not only kill their target organisms, but many other beneficial or neutral organisms. They are affecting not only the treated plot, but also the wider surroundings. These effects will decrease biological diversity in general. Sometimes keystone species like bees may also be affected. Agricultural practice of organic agriculture is partially reducing pathogen load on the fields. Remaining detrimental organisms are treated either by alternative methods, for example weeding or biological pest control, or by transitional agents, like copper or sulfur preparations. Nevertheless, doing without modern chemical pesticides often results in yield losses. In some cases, harvested crops may also contain increased amounts of fungal toxins harmful to humans. Monocropping. Modern farmers usually grow only one crop plant per field and season. All other plants in the fields are weeds and have to be removed. Below ground biological diversity, invisible to the naked eye, is strongly reduced by this practice, as well as by plowing, fertilization and pesticides. Traditionally, agricultural fields have been managed by crop rotation with regular changes in the crops cultivated in subsequent years. Due to economic reasons, this practice has been gradually abandoned, resulting in seasonal monocultures. Alternative to this detrimental practice encompass the re-establishment of crop rotation, application of cover crops, or establishment of intercropping. Such approaches refer to increased agricultural efforts without clear increases in yield. However, they may result in reduced needs for pesticide application and in an improvement of biodiversity and soil properties. Future. GPS-based precision farming may allow a more economic and targeted application of fertilizers and pesticides. Crop plants with increased fertilizer efficiency or pathogen resistance produced by conventional breeding or by genetic engineering may also contribute to reaching this aim, increasing environmental sustainability of conventional agriculture. And more thorough alternatives? The natural ecosystem is the clear alternative draft to the reductionist pot approach of conventional agriculture. Natural ecosystems can be very productive completely without fertilizer or pesticides. In many cases, they are also more resilient to stress when compared to agricultural fields. How do these systems work and what can we learn from them for our own nutrition? Is it possible to reconcile productivity, stress resilience and sustainability? Current ecological agriculture certainly is not the solution to all agricultural issues, but it allows to ask the right questions. When deciding about the appropriateness of agricultural management, it is important to measure all relevant effects. While it is easy to determine productivity of a given plot, stress resilience or biological intactness are much harder to measure. Candidate parameters like soil organic matter contents or biological diversity should become firmly established and should be used for guiding future agricultural policies.